Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade and welcome to a new tutorial series. This tutorial series is called Buttons Design and GameMaker Studio 2.3 because I like super long titles. And this video is going to be a short introduction to what we're going to cover in the remainder of the series. In this series, we're going to build a simple reusable button export. What I mean by that is we're going to build a set of buttons that aren't going to be super feature complete. They're not going to do everything you might want buttons to do, but they're going to do a lot of it, and they're going to be great for things like prototyping quickly and so on. You'll be able to turn it into an export, quickly import it into projects that you want to test things on. Essentially, it's what I already use for this exact thing, a set of simple, easily modifiable buttons that I can put into a project and be using to prototype something in less than 30 seconds. We're going to build this in 2.2.5 and 2.3, but we're really going to be using this project to talk about design in general, various design principles, how you think about designing something, and also to talk about designing and building something in 2.3. I was lucky enough to get into the public beta, and I think this will be a great opportunity to talk about some of the things that 2.3 allows you to do. And the way we're going to do it is we're going to build the entire project from scratch in 2.2.5, and then we're going to rebuild it entirely from scratch in 2.3. I might have a video where I try to import the first project into 2.3, but I think what's going to be helpful here is not importing a project, though of course there is value in that, but really thinking about how you would build the same system from the ground up in 2.3. Each video after this one is going to be marked with whether it is being built in 2.5 or 2.3, and we're going to start with, as I said, 2.5, which I think from now on I'm probably just going to call either 2.25 or pre-2.3. Lastly, I want to talk about something to keep in mind while watching this tutorial series, and I'm going to use a simple metaphor to explain what I mean. As you can see, here on the screen we have a picture of a chair. This is one type of chair, but these are also all chairs, and each chair is a little bit different from the other chair. And I'm sure that metaphor is obvious, but just to be explicit, buttons or things that you interact with are going to be in virtually every type of game that you build. And they're going to need to be different for every type of game. I'm going to focus on the general ideas and design principles behind it as much as possible, but ultimately I have to build something specific. So with this tutorial especially, you want to consider the things that I'm saying and maybe not follow them exactly. Build alternatives. Try to break it down into even smaller pieces. Think about what it would look like if you did it differently. You can use different variable names or coding styles. You could use different inputs than I'll be using, or you could just design an entirely different system while using this system as a way to compare or think about what you might want in your own. And of course, if I make any mistakes, let me know. Or if you come up with different and interesting ways to do the same things, let me know. All right, that's it for this introduction. Thank you for watching, and I'll be back soon with the first tutorial in the series.